I think this is going to be a short video. I hope it's going to be a short video because, you know, I'm in the middle of writing. I literally am in the middle of writing. But this came into my head and it's something that it bears repeating, like so many things to do with creative writing, it bears repeating. And so I'm happy to say it over and over again in all different, you know, from all different angles. But one thing that I think a lot of, especially newer writers that coming in to the game fail to appreciate is how important it is not to marry yourself to the very first idea that comes to you, which is not to say that you can't develop that and you can't make it into a story or write a book about it, but writing is about courting lots of ideas and giving yourself the time and the space to do that. So how does this play out in my world? You know, how do I see this sort of manifest? The thing that I see over and over again is when I'm running courses, such as the one I'm running at the moment, 4 weeks to write a picture book. I also run 4 weeks to write a junior fiction story. And I also run later in the year, and I'll be running it again, a middle grade magic course. Right. So these e-courses, each of them goes for 4 weeks. And often I get letters inquiring about the context of the emails is, can I do this course? I'm halfway through my book and I need to know this, that, and the other thing. And I want to bring my work in progress to the course. And what I always stress to people is I don't want you to bring something that's half written to the course. I want you to do the course so that you fine-tune your skills, so that you can take those skills back to your work in progress, back to the thing that you're passionate about and that you really see a future for. You can go back to that with the skills and experience that you gain in the course. The clue is in the name, right? 4 weeks to write a picture book. We literally, I walk you through writing a picture book separate to whatever it is that you're working on, so that you have an experience, a whole experience of writing one whole story. And by gaining that experience in a group setting with me nagging you along the way, you gain amazing skills that you can then take to your other stories. The names of these courses, 4 weeks to write a picture book, 4 weeks to write a junior fiction story, they're not 4 weeks to write a picture book for publication. All right. This is a sand pit. This is a playpen where you get to really understand the machinations of writing a picture book, of writing a junior fiction story, without that added pressure of thinking you're writing for publication or you're writing for critics or you're writing for somebody else to judge it. We're focusing on building your skill set via experience. And that's why in the first week of writing a picture, 4 weeks to write a picture book, we spend the whole time just inventing a character. We literally don't even set a writing goal in that first week. We just play with the ideas, the idea of how to create a character, how to bring a character to life, someone that we want to work with for this, for the next few weeks. All right, that's week one. And then in week two and three and four, we go into narrative arc and structure and setting goals and word limits and that kind of thing. And we work through all the little nuances, all the little bits and bobs that go together to make you a insightful and skilled picture book author who knows what they're doing. So how good is that? You know, you can free yourself from your whip, your work in progress, for 4 weeks, go off and write another story in the sandpit and gain experience, so that then when you come back to the thing that you're passionate about, you've got a much better idea of what you're doing and where you're going. But the goal of these courses is to get you to write something, something whole in the case of 4 weeks to write a picture book. All right, something with a beginning, a middle, and an end so that you've done it. Because the more stories you write, the better you are at writing. This is part of your training. This is part of your apprenticeship. So many aspiring authors want to go straight from, I've got an idea for a book, to a book. Like it's a one track, like it's a one trick pony. It's not. You need to acquire a lot of skills and a lot of confidence, a lot of insight into yourself as a writer, but into also the nature of story and writing stories. You need to collect a lot of knowledge and expertise in that area before you can zoom ahead to the published piece or the piece that you're ready, that you feel confident to submit. Are you with me? I think that being asked or required by these courses to put down your WIP is a breath of fresh air. You can come into the course not worrying about that thing you're tinkering with, not worrying about that beast that you're trying to wrangle into some sort of shape. You can put that aside for 4 weeks and just concentrate on getting some skills and hanging out with some other creators. You don't have to participate in the Facebook group. You don't have to do any of that, but you can sure as hell watch and listen. All right, and that's where you're going to pick up so much incidental learning. I had a big experience of this the other day. I'm you know, in my other life, grappling with learning the tarot, and it's a, you know, 78 cards and all these things going on, and I've been at it for a few years now. But so much of my learning comes from incidental learning, from listening to other people talk about the tarot and talk about their experiences and review tarot decks and all that sort of stuff. I'm just sitting there by osmosis collecting information, and little lights keep going on in my head. And it's the same for you. Every word you write takes you closer to the writer that you want to be. It also takes you closer to the story that you want to write, the ultimate story that you want to write. And I hope for you that there are many stories, not just one, because that's what it means to be an author. And it's particularly what it means to be an author of picture books. You've got to stockpile the stories. Don't just limit yourself to one. Even if your message is really quite refined, like you really know this is what you want to write about, there's something particularly that you're particularly passionate about that you want, and you want to get a message out there, I still recommend that you write lots of wobbly, silly old stories in the background. Practice your knitting, you know, don't try and knit an elaborate layette for the new baby when you're still working out, you know, knit one, purl one, all right? Let's take baby steps here. Let's get good at what we do, so that we feel empowered and we feel confident. I'm going to stop there because I've got to go back to my story. All right. But I just want to let you know, I just wanted to put that out there again. So I hope that's helpful to somebody out there, depending on when you watch this. I also wanted to put it out there that 4 weeks to write a picture book with me is actually starts on Monday, the 23rd of May. The cart is open at the moment of recording. So if you wanted to jump in and take advantage of the autumn sale and save big bucks, you can do so. If you want to know more about the course, just go over to the website, girlandduck.com, and click on, scroll, you'll see shop. Just hover over that and 4 weeks to write a picture book will come up. Click on 4 weeks to write a picture book and read all about it. There's a heap of information there, including what we do week by week, gently, gently, gently. There's also a little video sneak peek of what goes on inside the course. I'm only running the course once in 2022, so now's a great time to jump in and grab it. Even if you can't go through with the group, you can still grab the course, download it, and then you've got it to study at your own leisure. All right, at your own pace. You've got the material. You'll be drip fed all the videos, all the lessons, all the PDFs will be there, and you can come to it when you're ready. But it's a great chance to grab it this year, because I won't run it again because I got books to write. All right. Loads of love to you. And I will see you wherever, on the airwaves, on the tubes, in the newsletter, wherever. I'll see you again soon. Bye for now and good luck.